Hey guys, welcome to today's video. My name is Vienna Lay and I am your local real estate expert in the Dallas-Fort Worth area. So today we are going to talk about Zillow and third-party home websites. So what does this topic mean? Well, if you are interested in any way in real estate, whether you're a buyer or seller or real estate agent, you more than likely will be seeing this topic hovering a lot or being brought up in conversations regarding real estate. Now, if you don't know what I'm talking about, Zillow, where their primary job is to list homes in a certain area that you're looking at to purchase a home. And along with what homes are available to be purchased in that area, they also could provide more information regarding the house, such as the listing price, the description of the property, even as far as what the property is worth and school districts and number of beds and baths, all of that stuff. So basically it lists homes as well as the details of the homes that you're interested in looking at. So regarding the topic of these third-party home websites, we are going to be talking about how it influences real estate in the industry, as well as how it could be a benefit and a contradiction of interest or a problem, to say the least, when you are involved in real estate, whether as a consumer or as an agent who is in the industry. So that is what we're going to be talking about today. And with that in mind, let's go ahead and get started. So before we move on any further to the pros and cons of using these third-party websites, we first have to talk about what exactly they are and to have a much better understanding of what their job is, where they get their information from, all of that stuff, so that you guys can also conclude what you think of these websites. So basically Zillow, I'm just gonna say Zillow as a blanket term for these websites because it is the most used, I feel like. So just keep that in mind as I continue on with this video. So Zillow, it has all of this information, right, on these homes that are currently listed in an area that a buyer is looking at. And sellers would also use Zillow to look at their own house and get a Zestimate, right, for their house. And that is the number that they're going to ride or die more than likely when they talk to an agent on how much they want to list a home for. So this, it's almost false information in a way, the way that Zillow provides this information to its consumers and the people that use its website. So where does Zillow get this information in the first place? Now, for those of you who aren't in the real estate industry, like an agent such as myself, then you know that Zillow does not get these websites directly from the primary source. And I'm talking about, say, when I'm listing a house, I do not go to Zillow and put the information about a house in myself with my research. That is not how it works. Zillow actually gets it from a different private website, as well as tax information about a house that you're looking at, that basically becomes public information. So the information that gets taken to Zillow is actually from something called the MLS, aka the Multiple Listing Service. And that is a private system, I should say, not a website. It's a private system that us real estate agents and brokerages use and we pay for to get listings as soon as they're listed officially in the Multiple Listing Service. Now, that hence the name, right? So basically the moment I put a house on for sale, for example, I'll put it directly to the MLS, and everyone who's with the MLS gets to see it the moment it goes live on the market. So that's like essentially the official marketplace for houses. And so Zillow actually gets most of its information from that instead of it being primarily from the person who is listing. So what does that mean then for buyers and sellers? And how does this accurately portray information to its consumers? So honestly, it's not totally 100% accurate for people who are using Zillow, because the MLS, they get updated listings the moment it hits the market, the moment it goes live. And that is something we pay for, that we have exclusivity for, which is one of the many reasons you should be working with a realtor as a buyer or seller. And so when, by the time that, say, a buyer sees a house and it just hits the market on Zillow, there is a high chance that if you are in a hot market right now, more than likely that house may already be under contract or already sold. And that can 100% happen because it is a third-party website. It takes time for it to get that information from the MLS and from the tax information to the house. And depending on how hot the market is, you may be too late on seeing the house for it being available or not. So that is one of, I feel like, is the biggest con for buyers. You can get excited about a house that you see on Zillow and you show your realtor, if you're working with one, say, hey, I want to see this one. The realtor should have a look at it in the MLS where Zillow originally took that information, and they can say, okay, cool, it's still available. Or if it's a hot market, it may not be available anymore, and then you could be essentially wasting your time. Another thing for sellers is you're looking at Zestimates. Now, this is usually a big thing that could hinder a real estate agent's credibility in their work, is because of this darn Zestimate number that gets put up on the Zillow website. Now, why do people like me can't stand Zestimates? Well, that's because it's easy, right, for a potential seller to look at his estimate and say,
oh, that's how much my house is worth. Oh, that looks like a lot. So if the agent doesn't tell me that I can list it for this much, then I'm not going to list with them because I think it's worth this much because that's what the Zestimate says.
Or a buyer, for example, too, could look at a Zestimate and say,
I don't want to offer more than what the Zestimate says.
It could work both ways. So what is the Zestimate? So the Zestimate on Zillow takes into account the public information of the number of houses sold around that area, like a certain circular radius in that area of what houses sold and what they sold for and all of that stuff, and public information like that that they can pull from tax records regarding the home and the surrounding homes. But that's basically it. Like, it takes just the public information that it pulls from the tax information, but it doesn't actually look at the house in a very objective, fine-tuned way. So the number that it pulls up is just, okay, well, these houses around the area sold for this amount, so judging by balancing out the amount for that neighborhood is how much that this house should be sold for. But keep in mind, it is not looking at the inside of the house. It is not looking at your number of beds and baths, and it's not looking at the condition of the house, the repairs needed to be done on that house. None of that. It's not taking into account of any of the little things that actually would matter when a buyer does look at that house, or potential buyer is looking at that house and says, I think it is actually worth this much because compared to the other homes, it's ABCD. it's not looking at all that stuff because Zillow's not a person. Zillow's not an appraiser. It's not going out there and looking at it with human eyes to tell you, ah, yes, with these other things in mind, I actually think it's worth this much. So that's another huge thing with Zestimates. You cannot rely on Zestimates to be a foolproof way of saying that your house is worth this much, this house is worth this much, I'm not going to pay more than this because this computer says it. It's just not, it's not correct. And I know it's so tempting to look at the number and say like, ah, that's it. It's right there for me, highlighted. It makes my job so much easier. But you could potentially be losing money either as a buyer or a seller if you rely on a Zestimate number, because the Zestimate number does not take into account of the objective things that, say, a real estate agent could go into a house and say like, hey, I actually think it's worth more than what the Zestimate says, or worth less, because it's not taking into account of all of these things that a computer can't look at. So please be very wary of Zestimates, especially. It is almost, if not always, false in terms of what the house is actually worth. So those are the big key features when I'm talking about Zillow and Zestimates and how it could potentially hinder a buyer or seller in the buying and selling process. So do not get caught up in the number on the Zestimate. It is more than likely not accurate. And using Zillow, where they list these homes, may not be up to date. So using these sites is really just what you should be using in the beginning as a buyer or seller to get your foot in the door and kind of get your eyes on some houses and kind of make a wish list of what you like. There's nothing wrong with that. But to actually use it for shopping and using it as your primary and only resource for looking at homes and potentially buying houses, I would strongly discourage. So instead, I'm going to offer you guys some additional advice on how to properly search for homes and save a lot of time, save a lot of headache from looking at these third-party home websites. So number one thing, as most, if not all of my videos have highlighted before, go work with a real estate agent, please. That is the first thing that any buyer seller should be doing anyway, because we are here 100% to make this easier. We're supposed to be here to help you make buying and selling so much easier. And one of those jobs that we have for you guys is being your ultimate resource of information. So we have the ins and outs of what's going on in the housing market, whether it's listings, what the market looks like, what area you're looking at. We'll find the connections and we'll find a way to make the process so much easier for you guys if you just come to us for help in the first place. And so it is very much more accessible to use these third-party websites, and that is fine. You can still use those. Just run them by with your real estate agent, which was step one, to make sure that these homes are still available. And if you're selling, you're going to be talking to your real estate agent anyways. And if they know what they're doing in terms of comps and marketing your property, knowing the neighborhood, seeing your house in person, they'll know what to price it at. So if you want to use Zillow as a buyer to look at homes, that's fine. Just be sure that when you send them over to your agent, that they will also look to make sure it's available before you guys go out to look at your next potential home. The other thing that a real estate agent may have, which is something that I do have, is I have an app. Since I am with Century 21, we have an app where it directly links a user to the multiple listing service. So you get to skip that third-party housing site. You get to skip all that and just go straight to the MLS. And you can only have access to that when you have a real estate agent. So that is another great resource and another great reason to work with an agent, because agents like me will have a ton of resources to get you to where you need to be as quickly and efficiently and as painless as possible. So I have an affiliation with Century 21. So we have this cool app that allows our clients to be connected directly to MLS. We just send you the app and you guys just get to look at listings the moment they hit the market. So you can be essentially ahead of a lot of buyers who are looking only at Zillow when you guys have the upper hand on looking directly from the primary source. So there are a lot of tips and tricks there that maybe I might not even know about, and some other brokerages may have some advantages over on how to get their buyers to look at homes more efficiently, whether it's through an app or through another service that gets them directly into the multiple listing service if you're working with an agent. So that's all I got to say about Zillow's and Zestimates. I hope that this became a lot more clear for you guys, for you buyers and sellers especially, on why agents tend to turn our noses up when we look at Zillow and Zestimates and all of that, because it could be confusing for you guys, because I know it is so tempting to go the easy route with just doing Zillow and all that, which, like I said, nothing wrong with that. Just run by it with your real estate agent. And have them fact check it essentially on what you're looking at, so that you're not wasting your time and we could make things go a lot smoother and easier in the transaction process and in the buying and selling process. But if you guys have any other questions or would like to also share something regarding this topic, then go ahead and leave a comment down below. And if you guys want to see any more of these types of videos, then go ahead and let me know as well. If you want someone to also get noticed, know a little more about this topic, then go ahead and share, like the video, subscribe, all of that stuff. There's a bunch of things you got to do on YouTube nowadays, but that's just an encouragement on my end to you guys if you found this information helpful. But yeah, that's all I got to say on the topic, and that is all. I guess I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.